Would you like to know why I feel that the CISSP is going to be the certification with the greatest return on investment in 2025? If so, this video is for you. Hi, my name's Mike Gibbs, and I'm the founder and CEO of Go Cloud Careers, and I've been an IT architect now for about 25 years, a network architect, a security architect, an enterprise architect, a business architect, and I loved every minute of it. Now, I've spent 2 decades training people just like you and getting them hired at Apple, at Amazon, at Cisco, at IBM, at Microsoft, Google, and many other wonderful companies, including Zscaler and Palo Alto in the security world. Now, I will tell you that there's some trends going on in cybersecurity that are the biggest reason I'm going to recommend the CISSP, and then I'm going to talk about other reasons about this exam and why this particular exam gives you so much mileage for your buck, so much for what you're doing for this particular certification. So the macroeconomic environment is as such that there's a global shortage of 4.7 million cybersecurity professionals. It is so bad that the World Economic Forum is concerned about the lack of cybersecurity people and its impact on the global economy. That's how bad it is. In the US alone, a recent study shows that there's about 663,000 cybersecurity professionals that are lacking right now. And we're noticing that the cybersecurity workforce is growing at about 12.6% annually. And the statistics are that by 2025, the lack of talent, or based upon the lack of people that can do it, will be the biggest and most dangerous things responsible for cybersecurity incidents. So this is good news for the architect. Really bad news for the world, but really great news for the architect. Here's why. It brings us back to our macroeconomic supply and demand curve. So I want you to watch this angle very carefully, and we'll see this intersection point in a second. When we have a greater number of people, let's say we've got a large supply or a large quantity, what you see is you'll have this intersection on a supply and demand curve, but the price is typically low. So if we look for a skill that there is a lot of, a commodity skill, there's a large supply, the price is typically low. Now, if we're missing 4.7 million people in cybersecurity globally, and this is global, now you've got a lack of supply and you still have a demand. So you see you've got a much higher intersection curve on what you get on the supply and demand curve. I'm only showing one side of it. And because of that, cybersecurity roles are going to pay very well, and they do pair very well. And depending upon the career that you actually pick, whether it's a cybersecurity architect, cybersecurity engineer, these roles are between about $150,000 and $300,000 a year. So there's a very good demand for cybersecurity roles. Now, it's going to take more skills than just the CISSP. I don't want you to think that a CISSP or any certifications is enough for these roles. But that CISSP has a lot of things going for it. So let's talk about what it has going for it, and it also has going for you. First, I'm going to talk about the CISSP exam. It is what I call a more challenging, medium difficult exam, as opposed to a super challenging exam. And I'll tell you what I mean. I was fortunate enough to actually pay or have a boot camp for CISSP training. It was a hard 45-hour week, but at the end of the week, they covered all the fundamentals in the CISSP. And it wasn't that hard for me to pass the CISSP thereafter. I will tell you, it was one of the more challenging exams I've done. But I had a good background before I took that CISSP boot camp. So I knew most of it already. I took that CISSP boot camp and I was good to go. I'll compare that to the CCIE, for which case I read about 75,000 pages, and I am not joking, did 1,000 hours of lab exams, and spent, you know, almost as much money as a car cost on training for it. That would be what I would call a super, super difficult exam. And the CISSP holds almost, not quite, but almost as much weight in the industry as a CCIE, and it's not that challenging. It's hard. It's hard enough to discourage the average person from doing it, And it's not hard enough that it's not impossible. You can do it, and you can do it without killing yourself, and it's not going to be the biggest challenge of your life. It's still going to be hard, but it's not going to be the worst challenge of your life. Now, another thing that it has going for it, which is the slight barrier to entry. Now, I wish there was no barrier to entry, but what happens is if a certification is free, everybody is certified. And in the end, if you goes back to the supply and demand curve, if you have a large quantity of people that can do something or that are certified, the certification tends to lose a lot. So the CISSP is what I call expensive enough certification. So it's about $750. And it's not like a CCIE where you've got to pay $1,700 or something crazy like that for the exam. And then you've got to pay for an airplane flight to go there and then a hotel stay. And it's got a failure rate that's so high that most people take it 3 and 4 times. The CISSP, you can take the exam, you can pass it if you prepare for it properly on your first attempt at 750. So you don't have a lot of people that are certified. And it's a very well-respected certification that's hard, but not that hard. So you can do it in a relatively reasonable period of time. So the opportunity cost of the CISSP versus investing your time somewhere else is not that great because you can do it in a reasonable period of time. CCIE, for example, you know, you're going to spend $15,000 to $30,000 of training to pass it. The CISSP, you could either get a good boot camp to pass it, or honestly, for this one, you could actually buy the official publications from the ISC squared and you could read that and you could dive deep on any questions that you had on any of those things and you could still pass it on your own. Whereas the CCI, that's just not going to happen. So there's something there. Now let's talk about the industry recognition. I will tell you that that CISSP is recognized everywhere. And I include CISSP training on pretty much all of our architecture programs. And the reason I do it is this. When I see a student of mine get CISSP certified, they start getting calls from recruiters and companies almost overnight. So it's that kind of industry value and industry recognition. Now, when you do the CISSP, or if you attend a CISSP training institute, you'll see that you have lawyers working in risk and compliance. You'll see that you have technology executives and CISOs. So it's not just respected by the technical team, it's respected by more in the bigger business side. So it's fairly versatile to bigger roles like a CISO. Now, it tends to be very credible as a certification because the CISSP kind of covers a little bit of everything, so you have no gaps. Now, I'm not going to say it's deep enough of everything for, say, an engineer, because it's not. But it provides what I call a really good set of strong security fundamentals. And once you have them, it almost puts you in the position where you know just a little bit about a lot of things. You still know what you don't know because it's a framework for learning for your future. And if you continue to learn, you're great. I also love that it's vendor neutral, and many companies do too, because it's not going to be a vendor-based certification, which is here's the name of something and how to configure it. It's going to teach you how to think and how to act and how to solve real-world problems and things that are actually associated with it, determining the counter risk and determining risk mitigation strategies and thinking about a security policy for the organization. So thinking about all those things, I really like the CISSP, plus what I've watched it do for people. It is an interview magnet when it sits on your resume. Because of these, because of the fact of the ability to be seen and perceived and the ability to get a good, strong fundamentals in security and the ability to be recognized by hiring managers and people across the world, I tend to like the CISSP. And the fact that you can do it relatively easily, and I'm not going to pretend it's easy, it's not, but it's comparatively easier to things like a CCIE or a CCDE. The time investment, the financial investment isn't that great for the reward that it actually provides. And then you can use that CISSP as a foundation to do more. And in many cases, it'll give you much of the cybersecurity fundamentals you need to grow. I'd say for an architect, it might be 20%, but 20% of a whole career in a single certification is incredible. And for that, it's one of the reasons I like the certification. So I hope you've enjoyed this video on why I think the CISSP is going to be the certification or one of the best certifications with the highest return on investment in 2025. If your goal is to become a cloud architect or a cloud security architect or a security architect or an enterprise architect or an AI architect, we've got webinars to help you in your career. Sign up for one of our free webinars and maybe a cloud webinar. And on any of these webinars, we can cover any career you want. We also have specialty webinars on enterprise architects, AI architects periodically too. So check the description of our videos for more information on that. We have free bucks in the description of this video to help you with your technology career. So please, I recommend go out and download some of those free bucks. They will help you in your career. And if you didn't know, we have a complete CISSP certification, AWS Solutions Architect certification, Azure Solutions Architect Expert, CCNA on our channel, and they're all free. So go find them on our YouTube channel and take advantage of these free resources we made to help you in your technology career. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to help you in your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now. Have a great day.